I know it's been a long day for you, okay, but we are very privileged to have in our midst Professor Sahasrabudhe of AICTE. You all know he is the AICTE chairman, so he pretty much runs the entire show in the entire country for all engineering colleges
and polytechnics.
And polytechnics. Thank you, Kannan. So, as you know, as a very brief introduction, Professor Sahasrabudhe has had, you know. So, okay. I'll keep it really brief then. Okay. So, you know, he's the AICTE chairman, but he has been an academic, and he was a professor at IIT Guwahati. So he's one of us.
He was a deputy director.
And he was also at College of Engineering, Pune. But you know, as people with passion don't have time to wait for formalities, I hand over the microphone to sir.
Thank you. A very good evening to all of you. I know that you have been working hard. I came here in the afternoon, but you must have started your work around 8:30. It's pretty late in the evening, and you have still something to do because you have to complete your projects so that next day, tomorrow, you will be showcasing that to the judges. So that part will go on anyway. So most exciting part is this hackathon has really revolutionized innovation and innovation ecosystem in the country. And you are part of that legacy. Because 3 years ago when we started in a small way, Smart India Hackathon, which was essentially that time only digital, you know, in terms of software based, we didn't know that how it will take shape. There were all doubting Thomases saying that, you know, how can you do all over India? You know, many people do hackathon only for the company, for their at most university level. You are launching it all India basis. But we were pretty confident. We worked hard. And then the result is today, within 3 years, starting from 40,000 in the first year, we have already reached 2 lakh plus students all over the country who are passionate to give back to the society in terms of solutions to different challenging problems which government, state governments, and the industries are throwing at you. So many of these ideas which I saw today here, today morning in NCL and ISER, and also in Forge in Coimbatore, in all the three places, and tomorrow I will see in IIT Delhi as well. And there's so much of passion, so much of work that has gone in, and I'm sure industry will be benefited by the work that you have been doing. Some of you will convert your work into a startup. You will become entrepreneurs. And instead of seeking jobs from big companies who pay 15 lakh, 20 lakh, you will give salaries of 10 lakh to 10 people. You know, that is the hope that we all have in you. And this innovation is very, very significant and important. Because no country in the world will progress without innovation and research. Then these two components are becoming very significant. All those countries who are successful in terms of their growth, they have depended on these two factors. And therefore, improving innovation was a very, very important task. So this sample hackathon was one experiment, but MHRD has already instituted one committee, which is called as MHRD's Innovation Committee in AICTE, lodged there. There are several people working round the clock. And how do we take this entrepreneurship and innovation to the masses? And that's where about 1,000 institutions have also set up innovation centers in their respective institutions. Every month we will give some challenge you will solve at the local end, and some of that will come to the national level. And that is how we can create a absolutely wonderful ecosystem for innovation. And a word of advice to all of you who are in second, third year of engineering. Some of you will become masters, PhD. Some of you will stop education at bachelor's, but get into industry, start your own industry. This ecosystem development is everybody's responsibility, not government, not only of the industry, but all of you who are the stakeholders who have been benefited by this, we should transfer it back to the society. And that's where Dr. Kannan, who will be speaking after me, a very wonderful man who has been a very passionate, open and free software, whichever is available, that movement he has been leading from IIT Bombay, and many institutions have been benefited by that. And so whatever you get from the society, I think we must give it back in some form or the other, not necessarily in form of only money. Some of you become rich, you please give back to your alma mater, to your state, to your society in terms of scholarships and money. But more importantly, how do you create that vibrant atmosphere in every campus? Thereby, our junior students who are studying there, they will get much better benefit, much better facilities than what you all enjoyed. You know, that is the spirit with which you take it forward. And I don't think I should keep on going. I wish you all the best, both in the tomorrow's result. But those who do not get a prize, don't get worried about that, because you have put in your best efforts. And that is the seed. That learning will take you a long way in your entire life, and you will be a much successful man than those who were not lucky enough to come here. Please remember, out of 120,000 and several teams who had submitted their ideas, 20,000 of them, only 250 have been called in those 18 centers. So you are the cream, de cream of cream, actually. And so there is a lot of hope and aspirations from the country, from everyone. So I'm sure you will be successful. You will make the country proud. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Professor Sahasrabudhe, for introducing me. So I'm really happy to be here, and congratulations to all of you that you have all come here. My name is Kannan Moudgalya. I'm a professor here. So of course, I have put this catchy title, $5 trillion economy. Actually, one person who already made us dream for this, that is none other than our beloved president, Dr. Abdul Kalam. He said, we should live in a developed country. There's no difference between the two, right? Now, we cannot become a developed country by sending a rocket to Moon or Mars only, right? In fact, it is more difficult to provide drinking water to everybody in the country than to send a rocket to the moon, okay? The next one, it is difficult to provide good engineering education to every student in the country. It is easier to start 5 new IITs, okay? Do you agree? So in other words, what we need is to all-around development. In fact, I believe that if everybody who finishes 12th, every student who finishes 12th can get a 5,000 rupee per month job or better, we will become a developed country overnight. That's it. Because everybody will have things to eat, 5,000 rupees, everybody. I mean, it seems very simple, but very difficult to achieve. Anyway, I'm going to share some of my thoughts based on the work that we have been doing. So we'll be happy to get your feedback also. Okay. So we want to construct a pyramid of excellence. Okay. So pyramid of excellence, it could be in various subjects: fluid mechanics, process simulation, circuit design, state structure design, whatever field you are working in. We would like to build a pyramid of excellence. And what happens in the top? I would want to have at least 500 such pyramids of excellence for a country of our size, maybe more. And I would like to have 100 people, experts, at the top of the pyramid, right? And who are they? So if 500 pyramids, you'll have 50,000 experts. Because they are so good, they can be placed anywhere in the world, right? And how are we going to select them? It is through their work, not through exams. Okay, I'm going to show you, and I call it an attainable pyramid of excellence. There are some unattainable pyramids of excellence. Can you think of an example? IIT is one. If you miss the test, that's it, right? It's an unattainable pyramid of excellence for most people. But I'm saying, let's not worry about that. Here is an attainable pyramid. I'm going to show you that everybody can move up the pyramid, reach the top, and be placed anywhere in the world, right? So how are we going to construct it? Through social media engineering. What is social media engineering? People contributing, getting together, doing things together, and things like that. So if you want to do social media engineering, first thing you have to do is, who is the population? right? Crowdsourcing, social media. What is the population? Okay, for us, the population is very easy, students and teachers. Okay? There are 1 million engineering students. All the college students, if you take, it is 10 million, 1 crore, maybe more. I'm just giving a ballpark number, right? Very large population that we have, that we are working with, right? And we would, that whole thing is the pyramid from bottom to top. And I'm going to talk about how to make the move up and possibly lift the whole pyramid. Can we do that? That'll be nice, right? That's when we become a developed country, right? Okay, once that you have the population identified, the next thing is you have to train them. You have to train them and say that this is how you can all contribute to the social media. Everybody participates, okay? So how does one train millions of students? Seems to be a big problem, okay? Our solution, we came up with a solution called spoken tutorial. I'll just briefly explain what it is. Important thing is it should be suitable for self-learning so that anybody who wants to move up the pyramid can learn by themselves, right? That's a first requisite. So we using a way of writing the script. You all know what a script is, right? Movies are made using a script. You might have heard director saying, oh, I had a great script, so I made a movie. So there is a script, okay? Except that I added a twist here. Can a beginner understand the script? If the beginner cannot understand, keep on improving the script. Just keep going round and round. Sometimes, so this makes it 10 times more difficult to create a script, create a video suitable for self-learning, guaranteed for self-learning. So the moment they say, yes, the beginner can understand, then you record a video using that script. So that is our method. We do spoken tutorial like this. That makes it suitable for self-learning. And we train 1 million students a year. We train 10 lakh students a year using spoken tutorials. For example, we conducted a workshop in the neighboring building. College teachers from across Mumbai came. We could even conduct a workshop in Myanmar, in Mandalay, Myanmar, which had no internet. No internet, no electricity. We waited for electricity to come to take this picture. You see, everybody is using laptop, no desktop. Because desktop cannot be operated on when there is no power, right? So we have created the bottommost layer. What is it? Training the population, lots of people, million people with spoken tutorial, right? Using this method. Then that population says, hey, I want to do something. I want to contribute. Okay, so we want to excite those people. Half the people might say, hey, it's okay. I wanted to know what it was. I went through it. I'm not at all interested. So let's not worry about that. But the remaining half might say, hey, I want to do something. I want to contribute. Okay, so what do? So we created something. I'm going to give examples. Students from across the country created something called Scilab Textbook Companion. What is it? 1,000 students created Scilab code. How many of you know about Scilab? Okay, how many of you know about MATLAB? Okay, this is something very similar. Okay? So basically what they did was, for every solved example of standard textbook, they gave Scilab code. Okay, we have lots of students. So 1,000 students participated and they wrote Scilab code for 75,000 examples. So I'm going to show you an example. Okay? In fact, I'm going to show you in a different way. Okay? I have 75,000 examples. Now, I wanted to set an example on partial fraction expansion. Right? You've heard of partial fraction expansion? After all, this is IIT, right? I should ask you some quiz. So partial fraction expansion, right? Unfortunately, I forgot the command and the syntax. I don't even know the command, so how will I do that? So what did I do? So I went to this. Oops. Let me do it here. So I went to Google and I said Scilab partial fraction expansion. So the moment I said that, it said, oh, finally it has come. It says PFSS. It says command name is PFSS. So then what do? I come to my 75,000 examples and I search under TBC code search. And I say PFSS. Then, I have to press this. It says 140 results found. 140 examples from various books that have coded this. Okay? So I went through this. So for example, various books are there. So this is Manke. So when it came to 27, I said, hey, I used it when I was a student. So let me see this example. So it takes me to on the cloud. It's on the cloud and it has this PFSS. See this? PFSS. Now it turns out that I can actually execute it. Okay? On the cloud. So I've got it. Now I'm going to ask somebody who is familiar with MATLAB. See this variables here, NUM and DEN. DEN is displayed, but not NUM. Can you say why? Semicolon. Okay, let's remove that semicolon, right? And execute it again. So I've got numerator. I've got denominator. So I've got a problem solved. Now, supposing I want to set a new problem, what do I do? Supposing I don't want this 8 here. I want to take 9. Execute. Now I have 9. So I have set my own problem. Now I can do this for 75,000 examples. So whether you are a chemical engineer, mechanical engineer, civil engineer, computer scientist, doesn't matter. Here is a great tool for you to set problems. Whether it is assignment, whether it is exam, whatever. Right? Fantastic. Right? So most teachers who see this say, wow, great thing, I'm going to use this. Okay? So now I have a calculation. The total money we spent to do this, thanks to MHRD, we spent a total of 2 crore. You may think 2 crore is a lot of money. I'm going to show you the next calculation. Its commercial counterpart, whatever that is, it employs 2,000 people. They work in Boston. Their salary is $100,000 a year. You can say 20 years, the cost is $4 billion, 20,000 crores. Yet, our people say, hey, SciLab is good. Of course, one can say, this is not everything. People will say, I want toolbox. I want this, I want that. SciLab doesn't have. But that's only for 1% of the people. For 99% of the people, what we have done with our own students is a lot better. Because it saves time. I can set paper. I can set assignment. I can set labs. Right? So this is the power of crowdsourcing. All created by our students. People all over the world are coming and using. Okay. So now we have done the second layer of the pyramid that they have started contributing. But this is something very simple. Very simple. Why is it very simple? Because you just saw the solved example, you gave SciLab code, verified it, that's all. But it gives confidence to these students. So now we are ready to go to the next level. What is it? They say that, hey, I can create a flow sheet now. I can do a CFD analysis. Okay, I'm going to show some examples. Okay? So for example, so there is a software called DWSim, Chemical Process Simulation. So using this, these students from across the country have created, can you see this? You can see the, what college, this is all Suratkal, Sastra, Pacific School of Engineering. Students from across the country, 130 flow sheets. And if you take electronic circuit design, lots of these. CFD, I have many. For example, I'll show you open form. cfd.fuzzy.in. Okay. Case study project. Completed case studies. So you can see that. What are the different things? It's of course difficult to read. Okay. Here it is. So you can see that once again now these are all different students from various colleges across the country. And CFD's analysis is a little more difficult. Okay? So, these are some examples of students from across the country contributing. In return, they get a certificate, honorarium, and a link. I know students who got summer internship because they participated. They sent the link. There are some students, there was a student from IIT Madras. He said that he got a Japanese internship because he sent the link. Another person got TA-ship in Rutgers University and so on. Okay, this I have already done. So, I have constructed a third layer of pyramid. By the way, it's all available to everybody. Anybody can participate. So, that's why I call it an attainable pyramid. Everybody can do it, go up. Now, I'm going to give some examples. I'm more or less done with my talk. You get the idea. So, for example, we wrote a joint paper. And if you see here, this person, Alois, is in Austria. See, this is 80. Whereas this guy is in, he's actually from Portugal and he's from University of Alabama. So what happened? They developed software. We created hardware in our lab here. Raspberry Pi based open PLC and sent it to them. And they tested with their software. And they said, hey, it works fine. So we said, let's write a paper. So I'm talking about the next level, right? People are doing, building things, and finally, they are getting recognized, okay? So we built two PLCs, used two open source software packages, sent the PLCs to Austria and Alabama. They became our friends. So we are exploring cloud, online exams, etc. Open source Gerber files on the board. So we will create these Gerber files and ask entrepreneurs to sell on GEM, that is government e-marketplace. So in fact, we are going to do that soon. Okay, this leads to collaborative research. So another example of a paper that we wrote with somebody in Peter Fitzen in Sweden. Okay, we wrote papers in INDC. It has an impact factor of 3.17. This also got accepted. So basically, it is possible, you know, of course, look at this, training, and they start contributing, and then next level, and then next level, and finally you keep going up, and you are at the top of the pyramid, because these people are so good. So progress up the pyramid is by performance, not through entrance exams. It's available to everybody, right? In fact, we are running a summer, FOSSI summer fellowship just now. Maybe some of your classmates are there. And what did we do? We sent information to 30,000 department heads saying that we have it. All of you, welcome. Here are 25 problems. If you solve that problem, you can come here for internship. It is not through exam. So they all learned something, solved it, and 7,500 people registered from across the country, 509 completed, and 79 people are here, another 15 people are in Delhi. So together we have taken about 90 people, and not through entrance exam. Some of them are from degree colleges, arts colleges, and so on. They are also, you know, they can also contribute. Our, by the way, our project is not restricted to only engineering. The moment they see the top people going up, then they say, hey, you know, I can also do it. And you can see this movement going up the pyramid, right? And the whole pyramid gets lifted. Because the moment they see this thing happening, the whole pyramid gets lifted. There are many other methods of constructing the pyramid. I'll just show one photograph. So we are about to start a large workshop on electronic circuit simulation. By the way, this is our team. I'm doing a strategy session. The FOSSI team is here. So to conclude, $5 trillion economy is not a pipe dream. That's an important thing. We need to have confidence. Our strength is our population. So we have to harness the energy right? You represent your colleges, but small number. But look at other people. They can also contribute. You know many of your friends who are better than you who didn't make it. That's what I used to think when I was a student in IIT Madras. I know my classmate didn't make it. I know that he was better. So there are many actually good people. So we should harness. We can achieve this goal. Let's work towards it. And so our work is funded by MHRD. I showed you a FOSSI team. Here is the spoken tutorial team. Do you recognize anybody here in this picture? See this? See Kasim? Yeah. Yeah, there he is. So I want to thank you. And thanks for your question. I wanted to do it fast so that I'll be happy to answer any questions you might have. And by the way, this can be done at every level. Every college can do this. Every college can do that, and it is not a pipe dream. We can do that. So the important thing is that we have, for example, my calculation is 500 pyramids. Maybe we need 1,000 pyramids in every topic. And if you can produce 100 people who can be placed anywhere in the world, the moment that happens, then everybody starts going up. And then what is the economic activity of that? It's fantastic. And it is all done by us. The entire work that you see here is developed in India. Okay? Only the coordination. Students from small colleges. That's the reason we want to put their names. Put their names. Right? Yes, you have a question? No, you have no question? Okay. So, Sharad, is it okay?
Yeah.
Okay. If you have any questions, you can ask. Otherwise, thank you very much. And really happy that you could all come. Yes, if you don't ask, I'm going to ask you questions.
I have an observation.
Yes.
See, during this session, I have discussed with some of the students, and I found that there are first-year students. They can start with open source instead of MATLAB or ANSYS. They should go to open form. I have told to a team that they should use open form because they asked me, can I get ANSYS license? I said, which version? They said 19. 19 is, you know, the recent one. We have some old version which is still running. They said, this is available. Then I said, at the same time, you should use open form.
Yeah. So, just to see this FOSSI, FOSSI.in. Go there, and then I would want all of you to participate. FOSSI.in. The other one is spoken tutorial. Just do a web search, spoken. These are the two projects. And then you might have seen that. In fact, our logo is there, FOSSI.in and spoken tutorial. So we are happy to be a part of this hackathon to help Professor Sharad Bhartiya in whatever way possible. Thank you very much.